Hello friends, I am Rohit Vats and you are watching me on the Facebook page of the Hindustan Times. And today we are in conversation with Rishita Bhatt and Mohit Banan, who are here to talk about their new film, Ishq Tera.
Yes, hi Rohit. So, and hello everyone.
Hello.
And so what exactly is the film about, Rishita?
The film is a romantic film, and we've seen so many love stories come through. We've seen, you know, emotional dramas, romantic comedies, etc., etc. Young college love stories. Love stories after marriage, before marriage, extramarital, etc. But this story is about this girl who plays a split character. She has a split personality disorder.
Is
She's
it?
Schizophrenic.
And is it schizophrenia or split personality
I would
disorder?
Like to say that ideally she's split in the, you know, her her behavior, because you know, people, when they have a dual characteristic where they have an alter ego taking you know, they're taking over their lives, they do not understand it. And what if you were in love with somebody like that?
Right.
And then after falling in love, getting married, you discover what goes on. And it's very rare that in a love story, some kind of intense love that is probably an everlasting love that can bring you through and bring that love story and journey through. It's very rare that you see something like that. And while you see this kind of an intense story of love and drama and emotions, you also as an audience discover that whether is this character going to be normal or not.
So those who have just tuned in, we are in conversation with Mohit Madan and Rishita Bhatt, ahead of their film Ishq Tera.
Yes.
And she says that she's playing a schizophrenic character in the film. And Mohit, what exactly is your character? Also, is this film based on some story?
The
real
film
story
is about a real story of a daughter who discovers that her mother is suffering through this, and how she's treated her medically also, but through a lot more emotional support.
Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of people don't understand these things in today's time. Jabki, I would want to say that it's a very, very common thing. And
right.
We do not, you know, give much, we might just term it medically ill or, mentally ill, or, you know, call it all sorts of names. If somebody's even in depression in today's time, nobody wants to go see a psychiatrist.
Right.
So I think it's a subject which is different. And
also, I think mental illness is something that we really need to talk about.
Yes, I think I've always believed, as a firm believer, mind over matter. And as human beings, we definitely need a good mental state and a balanced emotional life.
That's true.
So while you don't have that, you're never going to be a balanced human being.
When you were describing me about the film's basic premise, I also realized that, some years back, there was this film called You, Me or Hum.
Yes.
The film also had a similar
of a, but that was there was a connotation, I think, of a ghost, if I'm not wrong.
No, not exactly. So,
not,
no,
okay.
No. So that film was also about
I'm not sure.
You know, mental illness and
okay. Yeah. So for me, it was different because all the more a female protagonist playing this kind of a role and yet having some kind of a romantic and it's a romantic film because you talk about husband and wife and the journey that they have
and
together.
And interestingly, this is happening after the marriage.
Yes, pretty much.
This is how it happens in real life.
You see what
also
happens? There are triggers. These kind of personalities do not know it. It isn't something you discover or you're born with. It happens because of reasons untold, which you start discovering. And then because of the trigger points or whatever that's in their psyche, they start, you know, emerging as their personality.
Right. And so those who are watching us, because I can see that we have got audience from all over the world, Oman, Nepal and
Hello.
Everywhere.
Hi.
So if you want to know anything about the film from Mohit or from Rishita, all you need to do is to put your questions in the comment box below this video and we will be taking it from there. I can already see a lot of hi's and hellos here, but some questions will also work.
Yeah, it will help.
And they are here to answer all your questions. So coming back to the film, Mohit, you were telling me about the about your character and how did you go about it?
See, unfortunately, I play the husband who has to deal with the wife who has kids.
Why
so
unfortunate?
I'll tell you why unfortunate.
You were in love with a woman, you're not going to say
I'll tell
that.
You why unfortunate. Only because he comes to know later on, after his marriage, he comes to know that his wife is schizophrenic. I say unfortunately because I think all husbands go through a lot of
Look
things
at
in
him.
Their
so
lives.
So bad he is, no?
It's true.
But
are you married?
Yes, I am married.
So you know what I mean.
No.
No, I don't know. What do you mean?
No,
I don't know.
No.
You have to listen to your
It doesn't work right. like that.
I don't know.
Like
you better
said,
be careful. She's
like
watching.
Said,
she's
know,
watching.
Everybody's no,
that's
very
really
interesting
to say
on
camera.
I think it is true. Not on just camera, but I think even as human beings, we've got this whole psyche as women also and as men also. This whole gender thing. It just
yeah,
says,
so,
yeah, it's a psyche.
So this is what happens. In this film, okay, we always go through these things that, okay, women love more powerful than men. But in this film, Ishq Tera, the title itself, Ishq Tera, this is where it shows that even the guy can love as much. He is devoted to his wife. And when he comes to know that his wife is has a split personality or she's facing schizophrenia, how he overcomes that, does he leave her? Because nowadays, like she said earlier, people end up breaking up, splitting up. Generally, kya hota hai? Usually what happens is when people start judging you and saying ki that person is psycho or mad, distance yourselves from them. But you need to understand that it's wrong. When someone goes through mental disorder,
now I'm getting a feel about his character in the film. So,
yeah, so now you, when you understand people go through this,
he
try
had
and
more
understand
trauma than me actually.
Yeah,
now
try
that
and understand that
way.
People only require love and support. Understand each other, and so that's what my character does.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't really leave her side. He tries to understand what's going on and tries to get her
so
through it.
Tell us also about the director and his vision. Like, what exactly was the trigger point
you
of
know,
the
story? You know, because it was this girl who's written this story. She brought up this real life incident. I don't think she wanted to discuss about it,
mm-hmm.
but it is something that has been a personal story. So, I mean, not very, very personal, the way it was written, but about a mother and a daughter. So what happens is that when you have something like that, you know, you don't want to, I think, from even I asked the director the same thing before I, you know, signed. And I said, he's saying, you know, the thing is that such stories are very relevant in today's time and it's very, very common. But because it's going to be a film and, you know, the audiences haven't yet been, you know, accustomed to watching such cinema, we need to probably make it a more romantic kind of a film and put the protagonist as, you know, a woman who's in love with the man and the man love with the woman, a woman who's suffering.
Right.
And it started from there. And then when they took me through the script, it was very, very interesting, challenging, intriguing, questioning, too many questions that I wanted to understand that. Because, you know, every character has a different trigger. It isn't that it's a common thing.
The same thing will not work for every character.
Yeah, basically, you've got dengue that you're going to be in hospital. Then you're going to have the same kind of treatment or have a problem with, you know, it's not like
right,
that.
Right.
It's not one of those illnesses.
Right, right, I get it.
It is something which is very, very personal. So each one having a different trigger. So we based Leela and Kalpana out of those.
So the two characters are
Kalpana
called
Kalpana and Leela.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we have got a question from Vijay. Vijay is saying ki it's been a long time since we saw Rishita on the big screen. What happened?
What happened? Kya hua aapko? Like that?
Not exactly like that, but you were doing really big films and you have done so many films. Must be more than 35,
40
films.
You know, I'll tell you, as an actor, I started very young. And the reason, because of all that love and support you'll want to see me, I'm still here. And because I feel like reinventing myself. When I joined the Bollywood industry, I saw all cinema. I loved Hindi films and all the drama and action. But when I started, I was a very thinking, I still am a very thinking girl. What happened is, I could get bored with, you know.
Probably thinking
yeah.
did not go well with
so the thinking
idea
was, yeah,
films.
Exactly. Sometimes, you know, too many questions were there. But I think the cinema that I did was always different and commercial both. So doing all the big films, while I was not getting the kind of roles I wanted to explore as an actor, I did some regional work and
mm-hmm.
that gave me so much of critical acclaim. So it was satisfying. Again, I got back to doing some Bollywood films. And there was another film called Miss Tanak Zero that
mm-hmm.
it released. So that was again a different kind of a subject. I think I've been part of films that have been always different. And as an actor, whoever it is, I won't name them yet. But they were different in the way they were. Their approach to cinema was different. And I think when I look
probably
back,
they were there to work rather than
exactly.
doing good films.
And while they're working, they made a muck.
Right.
And I am told, and I think that advice still stays with me, that, you know, an actor's journey is never ending. You can keep exploring yourself. And now in today's time, there's so much. happening as an actor, and so much of, you know, with the beautiful audiences, these guys who are looking and watching and all, they accept films nowadays.
Right.
They're liking concept-based cinema.
Because why
and content.
I asked you that question, because be it that song from Hasil or be it the Ishq Baktas video, people still remember you for...
they remember Daku Daddy also, of all things in the world, Aankhon Mein Tera Hi Chehra. And, you know, it's I put my whole life into the medium, and I think after a point, as a human being, sometimes, you know, you need to be on your own, discover yourself. I can't be a machine. In creative field of work, no director can churn out movies or keep churning out work. It is difficult, and sometimes you need to be in your own space.
Also, at the pace that Bollywood makes film, it is really difficult to make good films.
Yeah, and the way it comes, I mean, even whether it's music, it's Bollywood, they're films and films and films and films, you know, and I like that very much, and I hope all of the films work, because as an industry we should be rich and growing. But now they're more, you know, I think they've understood that there's a niche audience and there is a certain audience and there are certain budgets and there are certain things. So now they kind of understand, which is why different cinema is getting its place.
Right.
And different why? Because I would say that even when we made Ashoka, it was a different film. It was talking about the
and
legendary
Ashoka.
Ashoka
was very different from the film, the kind of films that we saw at that time.
Exactly. So, yeah, and playing Devi as a Buddhist, I mean, from being
that
chubbly bubbly girl,
film, right?
Yeah, and being the chubbly bubbly girl, you know, to bring out that, I think I keep challenging my own self. I'm very bad to my own self, I feel sometimes.
So, we have got a question from Gangesh. Gangesh wants to know that now when you have explained your film Ishq Tera, so he's little confused that whether it's a romantic film or it's a thriller.
Oh, it's a thrilling romantic film.
Yeah.
I would say it can't be a thriller as such, but thriller not in the suspense drama. I wouldn't call it something where it's a murder mystery. Thrilling because it's a thrilling experience to see the character on celluloid playing two personalities.
Yeah.
Because, you know, when you watch these two on celluloid, you'll be like, okay, Kalpana and then Leela. Hey, what happened here? But you know, her trigger points make her what she is. And because it's romantic, because I have a husband who's catering and trying to tend and bring out the real actual girl back, it is going to be a romantic film. Because you know, nowadays I see divorce cases happening. People are, because there's some problem in the marriage, somebody's psycho, they call it psycho. But if you really love a person, you will see that person through depression or any kind of problem.
To,
you
stick
to
it.
Yeah, of course you do stick to it. So, which is why the love angle comes in.
So, those who have just tuned in, and we are in a really good conversation with Rishita and Mohit about their film Ishq Tera. So, if you want to know anything about from them about the film, all you need to do is to post those questions in the comment box below this video, and we'll be taking it from there. And so, now coming back to you, Mohit. So, she has this split personality disorder in the film, and she has two characters to play. How are you going to cope up with that?
See, end of the day, whether she's playing two or three characters, split personality,
yeah.
It's one for me. She's my wife. So I have to be there for her. I try to be there for her because it's not easy. There are a lot of battles that I have to face of my own. But coping up with someone who has a split personality, it's difficult because sometimes they themselves don't know what's going on and they don't even recognize you. Even though you're
married. So have you met
them.
Such characters in real life also for inspiration,
yeah.
Or you just like came from prepared for it?
So I think yes, I have, and I studied psychology. So somewhere I understand that subject, and I've seen people, and some, you know, they behave like suddenly they were, we want to call it, but it's not that genre. Some people behave like they were possessed, or they were, you know.
There are different types of
types,
right?
Yeah, exactly. And it depends on the extreme cases that happen, depending on what. Upon the intensity. So yes, but this is a little milder version, but yet it becomes an intense version in the film.
So if it happens to you in real life, how would you cope up with it?
Wow.
See, when I got the script, I said immediately a yes to it because my friend, she has schizophrenia. So I've seen this. You're saying, if how will you cope up with this? I've actually been there for someone who's had schizophrenia. So this is why I'm telling you.
Because I know like countless people who would run away from the situation. Like yeah, most of them are cowards.
They do.
Generally what happens is people don't remember you. But they do have a, you know, like a hazy memory key. Something or the other I remember about you. But this is what I'm saying. There's no medical treatment for it. You have to be there. You have to be loving. You have to be supportive. Don't run away from any situation. Face it. End of the day, we're all human beings. So support each other, understand each other, and spread love. So it's very easy to say that, you know, oh, this person is mad or psycho. Just judge them. It's very easy to do that. But it's very wrong that we do. We judge so quick. Because when it happens to someone, when it happens to you, only then you understand what's going on.
And how was the experience while you were shooting this film? Like, did you go through any phases of depression?
Honestly, not depression, but frustration. Because after, you know, there were moments, you know, you're playing a double role. At least you're going on a parallel track. You've got one character going on a linear pattern and the other one going on the same way. But when you're doing a character like this, imagine in one scene itself, you're one character and the other minute you're just another because of the trigger. So, and it doesn't happen like some jhatka doesn't happen. It's not like some attack happened. It is basically the thought process that takes place and then it happens.
It keeps happening at the back of your
head. Yes, and it is a constant back and forth kind of a journey. So a couple of scenes are very exhaustive. And I think I had to tell them that I need a breather. I can't take it.
And the film is releasing on 20th, right?
Yes.
So, and there are so many, like 4 or 5 other films are also releasing.
I'm told so, yeah.
So, what about that? Like, are you not afraid that there will be a lot of competition and this film may get, you know, get lost in this...
I think a lot of films have come and gone, okay? And frankly speaking, films are coming so many in a number, in a dozen actually, is because the audience wants more. After one film, within the same weekend, they want to watch more films. So I think every film has its own little place.
Audience as well, yeah.
Yeah.
So if I ask you, like, these are the three good points, it's like really USPs of this film, then what could
different
that
love
be?
Story, because it talks about an issue. And not just that, it is a very, very loving love story. We have really nice songs, which you might just be able to play for people. And or not, they can be on the digital portals and they'll find the song. Ish Tera is one of them.
We can also put links
oh,
there.
Oh, nice, yeah.
We can do
you
that.
Should. And you like it. One is Sunidhi and one is Shreya and Sonu. And because earlier we were thinking of titling this film Broken, there's one title track called Broken, but we didn't want it and they wanted to change it to a more Hindi audience. Thing. And yes, I think it will be something that will touch your heart and give you a message. It's a subject that I'm hoping that will be brought up in the near future about mental health.
I think somewhere or the other people can relate to this when you watch the film. You may know someone or you may have experienced something like this where you have to be there for someone and face the situation. So that's what we feel. It's a sweet love story. It's about love, family and commitment. So that's what's there in the film. I really hope you guys enjoy the film and support us.
So we are running short of time, but I can see a lot of good wishes coming
thank
your way.
You.
So
thank you,
people want
thank
to
you,
see
thank
this
you,
film.
Thank you.
And so we were in conversation with Rishita and Mohit before their film Ishq Tera, which is coming, which is releasing on 20th of this month.
Yes.
So go and watch it. So,
okay. thank you for saying that, Rohit. It was sweet of him. Instead of us saying it to you, sweet of you. Thank you.
So,
please
and
do.
We will come up with, very soon, we will come up with the review of Blackmail and Missing this week on Friday. So till then, thank you.